Welcome to Richfield High School as TSB Television continues its coverage of the Richfield Optimist Holiday Classic. I'm Mike Peden, and we have the second game in our round robin for the boys competition featuring the Northfield Raiders and the Richfield Spartans. Richfield at 4-3, Northfield at 4-3. And so we have a battle for teams trying to stay above the 500 mark. Richfield coming off an overtime win against St. Paul Johnson, a rivalry that has produced several close matchups over the years. Northfield trying to come off a loss to Minneapolis South, where a 10-0 run to begin the game was enough to dismantle their chances at victory. We'll talk more about the matchup in a moment. Let's take a quick look at the starting lineups. For Northfield, it's number 3, William Seberg at guard. He's a 6'3 senior. Number 5, Jacob Matheson, a 6-foot senior guard. Number 12, Eric Shepley. He's a 5'11 senior guard. Number 32, Luke Harris. He's a 6'6 freshman center. And number 42, Marcus Nelson, 6'1 freshman or senior forward. Richfield will start Deshaun Jones, a 6'3 senior forward, number 3. Jawan Ross, 5'7 junior guard, number 14. Number 15, Ed Guyton, 6'2 senior center. Number 23, Lewis Williams, 5'11 junior guard, and it's also his birthday today. And number 25, Nick Peterson, a 6'3 junior center. This was supposed to be a four-team tournament, but Prairie Seats canceled this event because they do not have any athletic teams. Of course, their history coming out in the last few months, and it has a lot of shady underbellies that need to be addressed before they try their hand in athletics again, at least legitimately. So we had to settle for a three-team round robin, so Richfield will be back here tomorrow afternoon to play Minneapolis South. The Tigers have the day off. Northfield will wear the white jerseys. Richfield will wear their maroon. As we mentioned yesterday, it's the first year that a boys bracket was added, and even though it didn't go according to form, hopefully it will add to the mystique that surrounds this event. Richfield with the first possession. This is Jawan Ross with the ball. Richfield will attempt to use an up-tempo game. They'll keep the ball. Let's take a quick look at the keys to the game. We talked about tempo. It's going to be a battle for both teams. Richfield wants to keep it high. Northfield wants to inhibit the acceleration. Richfield also wants to play some defense without fouling. Tenacious D, in the words of Omar McMillan, the Richfield head coach. And Northfield will look to contain Richfield's dribble penetration to negate their speed. That time, Richfield was a little too quick. Deshaun Jones couldn't handle the pass from Lewis Williams. Seberg is hit from the three-point line, and he will shoot three. Northfield did not have updated scoring figures to account for yesterday's matchup with South, but I can tell you that in yesterday's game, William Seberg had 13 points to lead his team. He scored the first 8 for Northfield. And makes all three. That doesn't happen often, boys or girls. And Northfield starts with a 3-0 lead. That's one way to score and slow down the tempo. Do it from the free throw line. And a blocking foul is called. The Northfield fans aren't happy about it, but that was a very loud thud. And that wasn't a shooting foul. The players thought it might have been, but there was no attempt for a shot, at least on that possession. Lewis Williams, top of the key, short. Northfield gets possession. And already a substitution as Godfrey Luke steps in for Richfield. Another element to note for this game, stamina. Northfield, their energy ran out a little bit. Steal, no basket, put back is good, and Richfield is on the board. That was Lewis Williams. Richfield's stamina was emptied a little too soon. Putting it down is Deshaun Jones. And Andy James is calling timeout in the opening stages of the first half. It's 4-3 in favor of Richfield. So to elaborate on that point, Northfield ran out of energy at the end of the Minneapolis South game. Their shots were not falling. Their three-pointers were a little bit short, and most of their perimeter shots were a little off the mark. And so they are looking to have enough in the tank to last with a team that likes to utilize speed. Richfield with another interception. It's Lewis Williams who gets the layup. Don't blink or you might miss Richfield and one of their athletic moves. Seaberg with the ball. And there's Jacob Matheson. Northfield with a lot of multi-sport athletes. Most of their players take part in at least two, and some do all three. No layup for Luke Harris, the 6'6 freshman. Williams bounces over to Luke, but no cool hand. Marcus Nelson with the rebound. Shepley bouncing it over to Luke Harris. Northfield with their first field goal. Ed Guyton. Deshaun Jones picks it up. Shot no good. Rebound Luke Harris. And Harris strains a three. Northfield takes the lead. Offensive foul called on Richfield. And score for Jawan Ross. It's a quick moving game. Jawan Ross with the deflection, so it will stay with Northfield. But pretty back and forth in the opening minutes. If you're Northfield, that has to give you a little more confidence. Because, as we mentioned in yesterday's game with Minneapolis South, the Tigers started on a 10-0 run in Northfield. Couldn't get within striking distance for the remainder of the game. Both teams looking to stay above 500. Of course, that doesn't mean much. With the playoff format, Deshaun Jones with a swish. Kick ball. So Northfield will inbound from the Richfield bench. Matheson thought about a three, but does a no look to Harris, who's blocked. Matheson picks it up, but the fadeaway is short. And Luke picks it up, but Seberg with the steal. Finds Matheson from the corner, but he's short again. That's Deshaun Jones on the rebound. Jones, charge. Matheson was set in time. That was the most sound aspect of Northfield's defense yesterday. They forced three charges on one of South's starters, Kenley Farrow to be precise, and Shipley with a runner. Northfield not afraid to take a hit or tied up a 10. Deshaun Jones is fouled. He will shoot a pair. Deshaun Jones averaging 22.3 points per game, his season high, 43. And in the Northfield-South game that Omar joined us for yesterday, one of the elements he talked about, as Jones makes both free throws, one of the elements he talked about was playing an up-down tempo. He doesn't stray from that. He may make adjustments to it, but he's not going to change speeds the way some other teams do. And he mentioned there are two different coaches at this level. You have coaches that will adjust their strategy altogether, and some that maintain their modus operandi. Northfield making some substitutions, getting the kiss off the glass is number 34, Joseph Eckhoff. He's one of the first players off the bench for the Raiders. Deshaun Jones dazzling the crowd. That's his second dunk. Is it too late to get him in the slam dunk contest in the All-Star game? Well, he's got a couple of years at least before he has to worry about that. He is a senior, so chances are, as Shepley is fouled by number 55, Patrick Dembley. I would imagine Deshaun Jones will at least be approached for the Inner City All-Star Classic and perhaps throw down a few dunks. Of course, that event has had its twists and turns in terms of the slam dunk contest. Northfield attempted to drive. Richfield shuts the door, and Eckhoff can't hit a three. Jones with a great vertical getting the rebound. Williams, no foul called there. And now Richfield will be hit with an over-the-back call.
Here is the foul. here so much yesterday, I can't be here that long today.
But we just heard that. This is exactly what happened.
My fault? Because I need to turn it up,
okay? Bob figured out. He said, he's got to pick you up. You're just wrong.
I might have forgot. I don't know.
We have a stoppage in play, and it may be related to what has happened to William Seaberg. That may be some bleeding that we're not aware of. Tough to tell. But of course, if at the sight of blood, regardless of how it got there, officials will stop play automatically as a safety precaution. Inbounding it for Northfield, Kellen Robidoux, 43. Shepley gets the coast-to-coast play against Richfield's interior defense. Williams finding Ross for three. Bullseye. Richfield playing a pressure defense on the half-court set, and that's something, as you may have heard Omar McMillan mention, he does not want his team to be playing too many half-court sets, especially against teams like Northfield that preferred in their tempo. Ross has the speed, but can't convert on the layup. Loose ball goes to Richfield. And the quick lob from Jordan Sims is good. Shepley driving. Pulls off a no look and one for Kellen Robidoux. Robidoux did not score a field goal in yesterday's contest against Richfield, making only two free throws. Three-point play is successful. Sims tried the no look, but the pass is off target. Northfield tried to throw it to Richfield's bench and sailed over everybody. Not intentionally, of course, but it counts as a turnover. Lewis Williams on the drive, in and out, gets his own rebound. And we're heading Northfield's direction. Thank you. course, what Richfield would like to do, this is a 19-17 game that they're leading in, but they want to intimidate with some defense. Jordan Sims, I'm not sure what happened there. And Jawan Ross fouls Jacob Matheson. That will send him to the charity stripe. Matheson had 9 points in yesterday's loss to Minneapolis South. And he gets on the board. Examining early trends as Matheson makes both free throws. Northfield very balanced offensively. Richfield going through primarily one option, that's Deshaun Jones, but when you put down 22 points a game, it's not surprising. Pass goes under the legs of Matheson. That came from number 14, Thomas McDonald on Northfield. Deshaun Jones has 10 points. The next player for Richfield is Jawan Ross with 5. Matheson with the rebound. But you're seeing Northfield hanging in there in ways they were unable to against Minneapolis South yesterday. And the longer they hang around with Richfield, nice behind the back move, and it finishes with a Lewis Williams basket. Jordan Sims set up the play. Williams up to 6 points. Seberg evades traffic. Used up the dribble, and Matheson and Eckhoff nearly tangled up, but nothing to worry about there. Matheson from the corner. That's short. And that was a key to watch in yesterday's game with Minneapolis South. And it will certainly be an element we examine again as Deshaun Jones drives but comes up too strong. The perimeter shots for Northfield. They were coming up short most of the time. And that usually is a signal of tired legs because you don't have a traveling violation on Seberg. You don't have enough energy to kick up and get that boost from your leap, from your legs, for the basket. It's not just arm strength, ladies and gentlemen. You use your legs in tandem in basketball. Six minutes and 58 seconds. Whatever happens, Northfield will take this as a learning tool. They're actually playing a lot of Minneapolis teams in the next few days in their schedule. South game yesterday. They'll have Minneapolis Southwest later in the year as they play in the Minnesota Conference, so they don't get a chance to see inside Metro. You can count that basket for Luke Harris. And Northfield refusing to leave this party. They play in the Minnesota Conference. They did not win a single game last year in the conference. Are hoping to improve on that mark. But overall, a fairly young team. Luke Harris, the tallest player, but he's a freshman. You have a few seniors that lead the starting core, but how about this for a distribution? 4 seniors and a freshman in Northfield starting 5. But as I mentioned, did not win a single game last year in the Minnesota Conference, the conference that formed out of the remnants of the old Lake Conference and a few other shifts, not quite as news-grabbing as the Division I realignments that have been taking place throughout college sports. But in the words of Andy James, the Northfield head coach, that has given the Northfield Raiders a mission of playing to prove something every time they go on the floor. He says, we haven't earned the right to play like they're comfortable. And he felt there wasn't enough communication on defense in yesterday's match with Minneapolis South. And offensively, there were some issues as well, but right now, the Raiders ignoring the trends of yesterday as we have a 23-22 game in favor of Richfield. Perhaps the closest game we have seen all season. Patrick Dembley tried a no-look to Sims, but the 6-6 frame of Luke Harris was too much. Shepley gets around Williams. Here's Eckhoff. He tried to find McDonald, but he couldn't hang on to the ball. Richfield turns it over. 6 minutes to play in the first half. One of the more exciting first halves we've seen in a while. Certainly in this tournament, most of the games were usually decided by this point. But this one will require a little more effort. Deshaun Jones with another rebound to his total. Dembley will add 3 points to his scoring total. That gets him on the board. It's a 4-point game again. Coincidentally, that is Richfield's largest lead thus far. A situation that favors Northfield, and Dembley will be called for the block. Richfield in the penalty. So going back to the keys, when Omar McMillan mentioned they need to play defense without fouling, Richfield having trouble with that intangible so far. Northfield still has 4 to give. 1-on-1 situation. And that sends Joseph Eckhoff to the line. And this gives Northfield an advantage. Anytime they can get to the free throw line, play pauses, and the Raiders get a chance to restore themselves. Dembley, runner, swish. Sands went to Shepley for 3, but it was off target. Lewis Williams speeds his way through and finds Jawan Ross, who gets the kiss off the glass. And you're seeing more distribution out of Richfield now, and that is helping them on this short run of theirs. Hunter Sands rejected by Deshaun Jones. An emphatic block for the senior forward. Seberg fakes the 3. Harris will try. but he's short. Rebound, Jordan Sims. Jump ball, possession arrow favors Richfield. Jones with a little roll this time. Jones, that's his second block in as many possessions. Unable to hit the three-pointers, Godfrey Luke, and we're going to Northfield's end. And a timeout is called with 3:31. It was a one-point game not too long ago, but Richfield has extended it to a nine-point lead, their largest of the game. Public address announcer giving our little production a little plug. Deshaun Jones up to a dozen points. Jawan Ross has seven. And again, going over the numbers for Richfield. This run initiated in part by the increase in production among Richfield's other options. That's not to say Deshaun Jones isn't doing his part. Northfield can't cut into that lead. Jordan Sims on the rebound. Jawan Ross is going to try to weave his way. How did he get that pass through to Jordan Sims, who finishes with a behind-the-back layup? They've got skill, finesse, and a little bit of theatrics. Northfield in a shooting rut right now, but hopefully Luke Harris reverses that trend for the Raiders. Dembley, and a reach-in foul is called against Richfield. It is an offensive foul, so no free throws are awarded because it's a player control situation. But for what it's worth, Northfield is in the double bonus. Richfield's largest lead is 11. And that foul is going to be charged to Lewis Williams. That's his third. And because Richfield has committed so many fouls, Northfield has played a clean game. Richfield may have the lead by a few points, but managing their depth will be a factor in the second half, as Omar McMillan has to manage the foul situation now. Seaberg has yet to make a field goal, which is a significant difference to yesterday's contest, in which she did not make a single free throw. But Seaberg is a perfect 5 of 5 from the free throw line. And that's one way to rack up points if you're not finding a shooting touch. Richfield's not going to slow things down, so they're going to need to play with a little more discipline defensively. Because now they're going to give Northfield to the free throw line. Is that goaltending? No! That's a block for Deshaun Jones. That's his third. He got there just in the nick of time, and Jawan Ross with the finish. I thought that was going to be a goaltending call, but Jones got up there just before the ball made a descending arc. If he gets that point, of course, then goaltending will be called, but Deshaun Jones, how about his performance on defense? Three blocks already, and we still have 18 more minutes to go. And change in this half, of course. Not quite as fancy. Oh, my. They'll try from three-point range instead. Bullseye! Eric Shipley. Usually works the other way around, but if you can't go inside, go outside. It's 36-30 in favor of Richfield now, but Northfield stunting the Richfield run for the moment. No good, and it's picked up by Luke Harris, who's in trouble. Seberg bouncing over to Matheson, and Northfield running a little fast break offense of their own. That's Joseph Eckhoff on the score. We've got a timeout called by Omar McMillan as Andy James and the Northfield crew are fired up with 52.8 left in the first half. So Richfield went up by as much as 11. Northfield has trimmed the margin to 4. Richfield theoretically could hope for the final shot. I highly doubt that, considering their tempo. No, here's a three-pointer, but that's short from Jawan Ross. And Northfield can run out the clock and make this a one-possession game going into the halftime intermission, which would be a significant boost of confidence. Again, this is a battle to stay above 500, both teams at 4-3, but still a long way to go in the season. Godfrey Luke with a steal. Ball is live, goes to Luke Harris, who draws the foul and one. We're already seeing a major difference in Harris's game. He only scored 8 points against South yesterday, has worked his way up to 12. And he makes this a one-point game. Richfield? Not quite. A big run to close the first half for Northfield, and they trim an 11-point margin to 1. It's 36-35 in favor of Richfield. But in terms of discipline, Northfield with a much bigger advantage. Richfield will have to manage the foul situation now. They've already got two players sitting with three. We'll discuss that in more detail after we pause for a few moments to review our first half numbers. You're watching the Richfield Optimist Holiday Classic on TSB Television. Welcome back to Richfield High School as TSB Television continues its coverage of the Richfield Optimist Holiday Classic. I'm Mike Peden, and I'm presenting the second day of the boys' round-robin format between Richfield and Northfield, and we have a tight one in our closest game for this entire tournament, literally 36-35 in favor of Richfield, and after a series of blowouts and lackluster games and matchups, we finally have a close game to entertain you fans watching online, watching on TV, on DVD, whatever media you're choosing. Recapping the scoring numbers for you, Deshaun Jones leading Richfield with 12 points, Jawan Ross has 9, Lewis Williams has 6, Patrick Dembley has 5, Jordan Sims with 4. Northfield, Luke Harris has the game lead right now with 13, Eric Shepley with 7, William Seberg has 5, and those are your notables. Northfield wearing white, Richfield wearing maroon. Richfield already has two players with three fouls. They did not have a very clean game defensively in the first half. Even though Deshaun Jones got a few blocks, he already has three. It's a consequence sometimes of playing an aggressive style the way Richfield does, as Deshaun Jones can't get the kiss off the glass. Rebound goes to Matheson. You may get more big stops, but you're also more prone to committing fouls and sending your opponent to the free throw line. That's one element that's helped Northfield hang with Richfield. And now it's Richfield drawing the charge. That was Godfrey Luke on the play. And after this, we've got another big game coming up for you, as the Richfield girls team hosts Bloomington Kennedy. Godfrey Luke with the baseline J. And that gets him on the board. Shepley over to Seberg, and he gets bumped by Jawan Ross, and that's going to be his second personal foul. Northfield going to the backcourt, which is legal on an inbound play. Now Northfield will attempt to employ their tempo. They look to feed inside to Matheson, and the ball is stolen. Jawan Ross bounces over to Sims, but Richfield didn't have the numbers for a fast break. Seberg does, and he scores, and Godfrey Luke is down. So Seberg with his first field goal of the game, that brings him up to seven, but Richfield played shorthanded. Godfrey Luke hit the deck and having a hard time getting up right now, and so Omar McMillan will evaluate the situation. You certainly hope he's okay. Godfrey Luke, a 5'7 junior guard, only scored 2 points today, but this would be a huge blow to Richfield's depth. But he gets up and he's able to walk, and he may have just taken a hard hit and may need a little bit of time for any stinging feeling to subside. But he seems to be okay, and that's a good sign. On the season, Luke averaging 3.5 points per game. But again, Richfield's depth is a concern right now, with two players already sitting with three fouls. So we resume play, and in the game, making his first appearance is Sam Bissans Wagner, number 33, taking the place of Luke. Deshaun Jones will go to the free throw line, making his second trip. Jones comes up empty, but look at him. Scramble for the rebound, and he'll get another try. And this time he gets a guaranteed two deuce because he scored on an and one. An impressive sequence for the senior forward. But you might expect that. You would expect that when you lead the team in scoring, and his season high, as we mentioned, 43 points. So if needed, comes up short again. Are you kidding me? Ed Guyton with an offensive rebound, and Richfield scores 4 points on that possession. In an orthodox fashion, but a mouth guard hits the floor, and the officials will stop play. Listening to the crowd reaction. Oh, that was comical. Offering a sarcastic response to seeing a mouth guard on the court. I've seen headbands, I've seen super balls, I've seen charges, but rarely mouth guards. Richfield draws another charge. And Northfield getting the fouls called against them now. Of course, in high school basketball, in all levels, the foul calls tend to even out at the end of the game, but certainly are they not required to. So something to keep an eye on. That would certainly help Richfield out if they can avoid foul trouble in the second half as they try to defend home territory. Ross no good. Ed Guyton with the offensive rebound. Picks up another one. And another. He is padding his numbers. That was scripted. There was no way he ad-libbed that. Oh, I'm kidding. So, good discipline and incredible tenacity there from Guyton, who's up to 4 points. And his offensive rebounds are certainly rising in meteoric levels. A new player in for Northfield, that's number 45, Brent McNamara. Here's Matheson. This time it's a blocking foul. Matheson has yet to make a field goal. And splits here. Slow-moving second half so far, but we've had a few timeout calls. Richfield will take a timeout here to settle things down. They do lead 44-38. If it were a battle of athleticism and highlight plays, Richfield will be winning that contest right now. But Northfield staying in there, and the longer they hang around, the more dangerous they could become in the closing stages of this contest. Mercy rule will not likely come into play. Richfield nearly throws it away, but Deshaun Jones gets there before it crosses the half-court line. Loses the handle, but finds Ross. Three-pointer no good, and the rebound. Northfield, they can play fast too. Eric Shepley again has that speed. They may not be able to match Richfield in lateral quickness, but they have enough agility to play Richfield's tempo, at least in short spurts. Deshaun Jones drains the 17-footer. Ross nearly gets the steal. It is picked up by Richfield. And with the spinorama move is Muhari Muhammad. Seberg and one. Seberg. foul is on Guyton. That's his third personal. And that's three players for the Spartans who have three fouls. Sieber can't complete the three-point play. And a scramble for the ball ends up in the hands of Richfield. Ross losing the handle. Shepley again. Stop, starts, and we have a jump ball. Possession arrow favors Richfield. Or no, it actually favors Northfield. Or it does favor Richfield. Which way am I going again? Is it a left or right turn to Albuquerque? Jones thought about a three, but Brett McNamara says no way. Luke back in the game. And Deshaun Jones with a little leap. Nearly as flexible as Jessica January. Normally, I would not recommend going one on three, but Jones was able to draw the foul. And the last time he went there, it was a very successful possession for him, even though he didn't make his free throws, getting the offensive rebound, missing the three-point play, but having a teammate step in there to get a four-point play out of that possession. So even if he misses both free throws, you still need to box out because Jones is just too fast, but he splits here, so he won't have that opportunity. But he does push the Richfield lead to seven. And we have a foul on Jones. That will be his second personal. Both teams already approaching the bonus threshold. And we still have a long way to go in the second half. Richfield ball. Offensive foul. And that's on Nick Peterson. That's his fourth, and that's probably why we haven't heard much of him in this game. And Omar McMillan not going to take any chances there, putting in Lewis Williams. Not the greatest game for Nick Peterson. And Richfield has tangoed with some of the top teams in 3A. Seberg trying to shake Ross, can't do it. Jones weaves around traffic and scores. Lewis Williams has to be careful, even though he subbed in for Peterson. He has three fouls. Seberg from the corner, bullseye. Seberg warming up now. He's up to a dozen. Jones is hacked. And Northfield now out of fouls to give. Substitution for Northfield. And we have Mr. UCLA joining us in the booth. I heard things didn't go so well for them last night in their Holiday Bowl.
Not much fun in Stalingrad, no, that's for sure.
Jones missing the 18-footer. Ross with the offensive board. And Free throws coming for Mohari Mohammed. Well, Alex, you might be here a while. We might have to wait a while for this next game to take place because we have a rough and tough matchup here with Northfield and Richfield.
Well, it looks like it, according to the score here.
Bobby Beaver.
Oh. We'll get this situated here. What is the score? 51-45? Mohammed missed that first one. I don't know if we can switch on the fly here. Not while we're recording, I don't believe, no. We have to wait for stoppage and play or a timeout or something, and then we can get you on. In fact, I'm going to get my equipment now here. Williams makes the three. The players aren't the only ones who can ad-lib in this circumstance, ladies and gentlemen. Scoring still coming in a flurry. That's Jacob Matheson on the bucket. Lewis Williams racing down on the other end. The points are racking up rapidly. And another foul. Richfield had one to give, but not anymore. Good now. I know I can hear myself. And Alex, I think your microphone's up and working now.
Okay, so. I think we're good.
Yes, we are good. So I can tell you it's 58-49 after we did that quick ad lib for you, and Richfield pulling away now. That was Ed Guyton on the basket. He has 6 points. And this is all with three fouls.
And the difference on that last possession there, Mike, obviously. And you're getting second and third opportunities like Richfield just did, that's going to be a big benefit.
All right, first I need to ask you, Chris, you can hear what we're saying, right? You can hear both of us. Well, that's disturbing. You may need to see a psychologist after that. As I don't, after our conversations, it can get very haunting, very harrowing.
If I hear two voices, I'm good. When I hear five or six, that's when I'm
So let's get the game reset here for you. Richfield leading 60-49. Both teams out of fouls to give. And Richfield with three timeouts left, Northfield with one. And it was going back and forth for a while, but since then, Richfield has pulled away.
Well, I think it's obvious here at the score, it's 60-49 at this point in the first half. I guess it's going to be very important for Northfield to keep it in that manageable range, you know, 10 to 12 points. If they can get in, get it down to 7 or 8 points, they'll have, certainly feel a lot better about themselves coming down the stretch.
You should have come here sooner. I could have used you for this game. Might have been a nice catharsis or a remedy or
something after last
therapy after what happened to UCLA
after last night's disaster in San Diego. Oh, anything would be good right now.
Well, when it becomes a Twitter meme overnight, you know it was a blowout game. That's something UCLA will want to forget, I'm sure. I know the Gophers are hoping to make some memories of their own tonight in the Meineke Car Care Bowl.
Dangerous pass there.
So Richfield and Northfield, as we mentioned, both teams looking to stay above 500, and with Richfield up by 11, it's a key point. Their senior captains put together a covenant, and we'll talk about that in a little bit here. Unable to get the runner is Eric Shepley. The covenant was four things: be prepared, be disciplined, stay together, and play tough. And that's starting to show here in the second half. Richfield got into some foul trouble early in the first that allowed Northfield to hang around. They're playing a much more poised game in the second half, although getting Marcus Nelson got the short-range J.
Great no-look pass by Sonis there on that one.
Richfield, though, using their blistering tempo to keep Northfield in check. And Deshaun Jones has had some strong defensive efforts. He has three blocks. As Richfield looking to pull away. Guyton. Yes. Well, Guyton did not have four fouls as we first thought. Peterson does. But with Richfield getting a bit of cushioning here, it will certainly help their case. That's Hunter Sands. And Shepley for three. That's a huge nice three-pointer for Eric Shepley. Richfield can't get the quick response. And here comes Northfield. I'll give you a copy of the program so you can at least keep up with some of the names here. But the way the tempo was going, it's almost blinking. You'll miss something. That's how quick it's been going. Richfield up 62-54. Luke Harris, long two swish. Harris having a phenomenal game today, 17 points, and he's a freshman, 6'6".
Good patience there by Northfield on that possession, Mike.
Omar McMillan will call timeout. It's a six-point game, 62-56, with 6 minutes and 41 seconds left in this contest.
Good job by Northfield, you know, keeping their poise when they got down by that double-digit margin.
They've been down by, go ahead.
I would just say, you know, down by that double-digit margin, you know, they kept it poised. They've cut it back down to single digits. Much more manageable deficit here, as I was saying earlier.
They were down by 11 twice. They came back to close the halftime margin within one. And now they're threatening again, and a big difference is just their tenacity. They couldn't respond to a 10-0 run from Minneapolis South yesterday, and that's what led to their loss. Here, big difference. William Seberg, he's on par with yesterday's numbers, but Luke Harris, up to 17 points. He only scored 8 in the first game, or in yesterday's game, and Eric Shepley also putting in some bigger numbers. He has 12 points as of now, only 6 against Minneapolis South.
Andy Jeans, the head coach at Northfield for many years on the Carleton women's basketball staff there when Tammy Metcalf-Filson was the head coach there.
Mr. Mayak, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, Alex will be with me for the Richfield-Bloomington-Kennedy game, which should be another fireworks display as the number 6 team in 3A battles the number 3 team in 4A.
Oh, what a move.
And speaking of fireworks, Patrick Dembley going boom, boom, boom. I think we have a photographer who might be taking pictures of us, or that guy. Not sure. Reach and foul, and again, Northfield in the penalty, so Richfield with the chance to increase the distance here, increase the lead, I should say.
Those are those opportunities here in that last position by Northfield where you got to finish. Robodeau had the good look at it, but he just couldn't finish. He put it up a little hurriedly.
That will send Ed Guyton to the line. He is the stepbrother, the younger stepbrother of Brianne Guyton, who is now a Richfield alum. But he misses on the 1-1. But Northfield can't hang on to it. Two players collided with each other, and it's a classic case of too many chefs spoiling the broth.
That can and will happen.
Happens in baseball, too. A missed chance for Northfield, and Richfield, interesting situation here. Luke missing the three-pointer. They like to play quick, but you do wonder if they try to slow down the tempo. Northfield likes to play it a little more, but that would kill some clock, and when you're trying to win a ball game, when you're up by eight, the clock should be your best friend. We'll see what happens. No look pass, Ed Guyton scores. Deshaun Jones on the assist. Northfield says, anything you can do, I can do better. Marcus Nelson scoring off a similar play. Jones loses the ball, but a foul is called. And it will be charged against Richfield. Yes. And that will send Northfield to the line. Again, both teams in the penalty.
Northfield continuing to hang tough here, Mike, against a lot of adversity.
Jacob Matheson at the line. He has 5 points. Just one field goal, but key stretch here. And he comes up empty, but Northfield will get possession, and that tripod is taking a beating these 2 days. That's the third time a ball has made contact with it. Luke Harris, that's long. McDonald, no.
Boy, I almost that's thought Marcus that was Nelson. Basket interference there, Mike.
That's the second near goaltend on Richfield, but give them credit. They've been playing some solid defense.
Oh, and what a steal.
Speaking of defense, that's Eric Shepley.
Nice steal by Shepley.
And he
alert.
Finished. He's up
alert
to 14.
Play.
It's a 6-point game. It's a 2-possession margin. Richfield now decision time. They do have a 6-point lead, and they could milk clock. Jones for three. Bullseye. That's a huge three-pointer in the late stages of this game.
Yep.
Charge. Player control foul, so no free throws awarded.
Charge on Seberg there.
That's his third, and Richfield has a chance to close out here.
Yeah.
Assembly open in the corner. Yes! That could be the metaphorical icing as we're under 4 minutes. Richfield up by 12, their largest lead of the game.
Crunch time now here for Northfield, Mike. See if they can whittle it back down again.
They ran out of energy against Minneapolis South, and stamina could be an issue here, but Luke Harris says we've learned a thing or two about endurance from yesterday. He's up to 20 points. Kick ball. It will stay with Richfield, but again, Richfield in the driver's seat. They do have a 9-point lead. And even though 3 minutes and 27 seconds is plenty of time and basketball terminology, Richfield is in position to milk the clock. Guyton, that was a tough shot. But Richfield, again, too many jerseys in one area and no one able to get position. Ross to Deshaun Jones. Jones with 22, matching his average. Jones, baseline drive, almost had the dunk. He's put a couple down today. And Northfield, as you said, crunch time. They need to score and score quickly. They get the quick basket. That's Marcus Nelson, who's up to 6. It's a 7-point game now. Richfield needs good possessions here. They do not want to commit a turnover, and if they don't score, they want to take some time off the clock. That may have been a little too quick. Ball goes to Richfield. Jones has an open Williams. Yes! The birthday boy up to 14 points. And the lead is up to 9 again with 2 minutes to play. Northfield may be thinking 3-point ball right about now.
You're right, Mike, and they got it.
Jacob Matheson.
Northfield continuing to come up with clutch baskets here when they appear to be in a heap of trouble.
It's a 6-point game again, but they still need a couple of stops. Off the screen, Demblar couldn't get in position, or Dembley, I should say. Omar McMillan wanted a foul call, didn't get it, and Northfield, outside chance, but it exists nonetheless. It's a 2-possession game now. Harris has a strong game. Matheson from the corner. Bullseye!
How about that?
What did I say about the metaphorical icing? I think right now that icing and the rest of the cake would go splat on my face.
Well, I tell you, you got to give Northfield a lot of credit. You know, at least 3 times now we've seen them in a heap of trouble just in this first half alone. And each time, Mike, they've been able to battle it back and get it down to single digits. Right now they're only down by 3, and they've got to feel really good about themselves here coming down the stretch.
But now it's time to play clock management. If you're Richfield, you have a little over a minute to play. In the driver's seat again, looking at the fouls, they are in the double bonus, so any foul Northfield commits is an automatic 2 free throws.
Absolutely, this is
and
where...
I would consider making Northfield play that game right about now.
Yeah, I would think so too. This is where you want to have a smart possession, take care of the rock, work yourself into a good shot, see if you can get it down low, draw a foul, and get to the line.
Chris, what would you do?
Take pictures.
He'd take pictures. Well, I might need you for the state tournament if you're around in March. 1:11. Richfield in another close contest. They had to sweat out an overtime victory with St. Paul Johnson last Saturday. Oh, Seberg was looking for a steal. He's still eyeing the ball. Northfield would love to snipe it away. Richfield has one timeout left. It will stay with the Spartans. It was deflected off of Shepley. Or I should say Richfield has two timeouts left. Northfield out of...
With a lot of hustle there, Mike.
Northfield out of timeouts. So if Northfield does get a steal and a score, they could not stop the clock, and that's exactly what Northfield had to do there. That's going to be the fourth foul on Seberg, but Northfield, knowing there is no shot clock, figuring we have to go for steals to have a legitimate chance.
Got to admire the aggressiveness of this Northfield team here, Mike. They're really going after it. Not afraid to take chances here.
And this is a big possession. Jawan Ross missing the front end. He needs to make this to force a two-possession game. And he does. That brings him up to 10. And that covenant I talked to you about, the senior captains created it, and it's up to them to hold the players accountable, including themselves. And now Richfield will have to hold themselves accountable here on defense, but they leave Shepley alone. His three-pointer is short and off the backboard, which counts as out of bounds. So a dead ball rebound to Richfield. And this was the best possible situation the Spartans could hope for. But they need to get the inbound play in. And Northfield playing a full court defense Richfield not used to seeing.
Ooh.
And it pays off. Matheson with the steal. Shepley, left wing, bullseye!
Wow.
Richfield will opt not to use a timeout. They go for the fast break instead, and they draw the foul. Jawan Ross,
Deshaun,
facing crunch time again.
Deshaun Jones went down awfully hard on that fast break opportunity, but appears to be all right.
The foul is on Marcus Nelson, and he has fouled out. He will finish with 6 points. Andy James calling for a quick huddle. Of course, you get 30 seconds to make a substitution in that situation. This game reminds me of the 3A state championship last year that went into overtime between De La Salle and Washburn, and which was decided on a buzzer beater from A.J. Barker, but it was a case where both teams converted on fast break opportunities in the closing seconds. In fact, the final 18 seconds, I believe, was so dramatic it made the SportsCenter highlights. Jawan Ross, averaging just 9.3 points per game, and if he makes
big
this.
Second free throw here now.
And he does. Northfield cannot stop the clock. They do not have a timeout, so that's off of Richfield. It's a big decision, time now for the Raiders. They have 22 seconds. Wow.
Wow. Wow was right, Mike.
The foul is on Dembley. That's his fourth, but Richfield in the penalty. So Northfield goes to the free throw line, and the clock stays at 22.6. Shepley with 17 points. He had six, just six, against Minneapolis South just 24 hours ago.
Ooh.
That comes up empty. Now Northfield has to foul. And Deshaun Jones can ice the game here.
Ooh, big miss there. Still a chance to make this a two-possession game, Mike.
Well, he needs to make this one. Jones with 22 points.
Missed them both.
He leaves the door open. Northfield, will they hold? Or will they go for it?
Oh,
steal! Demblar, open! And that will stay with Richfield with 5.2 seconds remaining. How many chances has Northfield had to tie the game?
Yeah, you know, I'm a little surprised that they didn't try to call a timeout. Well, of course, they were out of timeouts anyway, but.
Well, Northfield is out of timeouts, and Richfield hanging on to their two so that Northfield can't set up their defense. Again, utilizing that fast tempo game, but not over yet. Richfield still has to get the inbound in, and they do. And Jones will get in with 4.2 left. You figure now, if Jones makes even one of these,
that would pretty much do it.
But it's not a sure thing, and Jones has not shot well from the free throw line today, and Omar McMillan will call timeout to go over the situation. Well, we know what's on the line. We don't need to extrapolate there or really dissect any situation other than this. If Richfield or if Jones makes one of two, the game is effectively over. If he misses both, Northfield will have one more chance.
Yeah.
So I think, obviously, before you discuss any strategy, we have to see what Jones does at the free throw line. But should he miss both, and Northfield, they wouldn't have much time, but they could. They could get a shot up. They'd have to do it on the fly, of course.
They absolutely. They won't have a lot of time just
because
to get
again,
the ball up the floor,
well,
much less set up for a good shot.
It would have to be kind of a heave or a Hail Mary of sorts because, again, they are out of timeout, so they cannot stop the clock if they get this inbound. Again, though, the first step in this equation, what will Jones do? He just needs to make one.
Well, let's see what happens here.
And Richfield can breathe easy now.
A little easier.
Richfield survives a scare.
Wow.
78-74. But you got to give credit to Northfield for not backing down. They were down by 12, 11.
Every time
they fought back to one possession.
You know, in those last two chances when they had an opportunity to at least tie it up, you know, just a couple of small mistakes prevented them from doing that. But still, I think coming into a hostile environment here and performing very well against a very talented Richfield squad, I think Northfield will take a lot from this game.
And so can Richfield. They had to sweat one out with Johnson, sweat one out with Northfield. Just another reminder that there's never an easy game at this level. Just recapping the scoring for you, the high score, Deshaun Jones with 23 points for Richfield, Lewis Williams with 14, Jawan Ross with 12. For Northfield, Luke Harris finishes with 20 points to lead the team. Eric Shepley had 17. William Seberg with 12. And those are your notables in that category. Well, thanks for spending the last few minutes with us, Alex. And, of course, he'll be with us in a few minutes to bring you the Richfield-Kennedy girls game in the championship round of the girls bracket.
That'll be fun.
For everyone here at TSB Television, I'm Mike Beaton. Thank you for watching.